Satyajit Das is an internationally respected expert in finance with over 35 years of experience. In 2014, Bloomberg nominated him as one of the 50 most influential financial thinkers in the world. He's worked for Citigroup, Merrill Lynch, and the TNT Group, and he has acted as a consultant advising banks, investors, corporations, and central banks around the world. Das, you were also in Charles Ferguson's 2010 Oscar-winning documentary Inside Job and the 2012 PBS Frontline series Money, Power, and Wall Street. And your latest book is The Age of Stagnation, Why Perpetual Growth is Unattainable and the Global Economy is in Peril. It was just released earlier this year. And like yourself, another well-known individual that predicted the global financial crisis of 2008, Nouriel Roubini, calls your book provocative and says that it should be widely read. So with that said, let's start off by asking the question, what is so provocative about your new book, Das, and why do you think people need to read it?
Well, the first thing I'll tell you something very funny about the book is its title originally was A Banquet of Consequences. And that's the title under which it's been published in other parts of the world. But the American publisher decided that it sounded too much like a cookbook. So we went with Age of Stagnation. So it's kind of a history the title. But what is interesting about the book is several things. The first is most people actually accept that growth by way of improved living standards and greater prosperity is just a given, which I think is actually an aberration of the post-war period. So after World War II, we created this sort of mythology, and we're now reaching the end of that. The second part of that mythology, which is kind of crucial, is the fact that essentially policymakers had these little levers and they could pull these and somehow miraculously achieve the outcomes they wished. And to a large extent, that was true until probably about 2007, 2008. And what I think is interesting is what we're now seeing playing out is the two things that we've just mentioned unraveling. And so the book, to some extent, is controversial, and pretty much it's upset everybody. I think anybody who's read it has been upset by it, because I sort of say the emperor has no clothes, and essentially that we can't actually rely on these two premises going forward. And part of that is, which is unusual for a book on this particular subject matter, what I've tried to do is look at the failure of our models, our economic models, if you like, not only in terms of finance. So I cover things like the issues of debt, entitlements, but I also cover certain other factors which people actually frequently ignore, which is things like demographics. I also cover things like the problem of resource scarcity. People forget that we only really talk about energy, but every year we need more water and we need a new Rhine River every year to meet the water needs of the planet. And also people forget that food production is increasingly constrained because we need to increase food production by 50% in the next probably several decades. And it's not clear where that's going to come from. And also what has really upset people, particularly the technophiles in the world, is I'm saying that, okay, well, what are the solutions to this? All the financial engineering that central banks and everybody else is trying to do is not going to work. It hasn't worked so far, and there's no evidence that it's going to work. And also the other thing which politicians in particular and policymakers have embraced, which is the idea of technology will save us, may also be actually false, because people have this strange view of technology and it's sort of like the last resort, which is if everything else fails, technology will save us. I always question that for a number of reasons. One is, as Robert Gordon has pointed out, that the real innovations were really in the 19th century, in the second industrial revolution, things like electricity, internal combustion engines. But more importantly, from my perspective, I think that one of the big problems is that technology frequently causes a lot of problems, because problems of carbon emissions came about because of technology. And I also cover things like the actual problems of inequality, and also what this period of history has done, and which I think is playing out at the moment, is the breakdown in trust between, obviously, countries, with institutions, with things like money, with things like policymakers, which I think is creating a very fragile and complex environment, which we're seeing, for instance, in the United States and other places, with the rise of populist leaders or aspiring leaders with some interesting views on what they would like to do. So the book tries to give a holistic picture of how all of these things interact in this particular environment. And I've also tried to make sure that people understand that the choices are not going to be easy. And secondly, they're going to mean quite a lot of sacrifice in terms of living standards. Of course, that makes the book about as popular as Ebola virus.
There's a lot of topics that you just went into, and I would like to pick apart and go through many of those as we can in today's interview. But let's start with the title. I guess that's the American release, The Age of Stagnation. Like you said, in other parts of the world, it's known as Banquet of Consequences. But let's talk about stagnation first and foremost, and why you think that that's kind of the long-term mode that we're going to be moving into, and get into growth. First of all, why do we need growth so much? Why is it so important to the world today? And then why are we not seeing it?
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's financialsense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.